You guys, this is part two. If you haven't checked out part one, make sure you do that first. The link is in the description below, or hit the thumbnail now and enjoy watching. So what was your marketing approach when you got started? What's some of the biggest mistakes you've made in starting this business? And what's the most necessary equipment for starting a t-shirt business? The most important thing, t-shirt printing business, these are the three things you need to focus on. So what made you get into the brand with Big Frog? I mean, were you looking for a frog business in some sort of fashion? What was the appeal for you ultimately about the t-shirt business that you're now in 9 years later?
Yeah, so when I was in limbo and I was looking for getting into a business by myself, the idea of franchising, excuse me, came across, and you know, it was that famous quote, I think Ray Kroc came up with, you know, you want to be in business for yourself and not by yourself. And
right. That
appealed to me.
Okay.
So when I was looking at some businesses to buy, and the broker was like, you know, here, check out this Big Frog custom t-shirts. My initial reaction was like, I'm not opening up a t-shirt shop. And he's like, no, really, check them out. And I flew out to the headquarters in Florida, mm-hmm. and they had a mock store. I met the executives, the franchisors, and I was like, I can do this. This is cool.
Nice.
I'm into
okay.
this.
So what was your marketing approach when you got started, and has it changed in any way at year 9 or 10? Can you give us the bulk story of that?
So my marketing experience over the years has kind of varied. In the beginning, it was a lot of print media, newspapers, the local papers. There was a radio ad that I had done. I did a short television commercial. A lot of direct mailers. Mm-hmm. Thousands of direct mailers.
It's expensive though, isn't it?
It is super expensive. And because it was expensive and I wasn't getting a great return, you know, I was just kind of just trying different things, trying mm-hmm. to get the word out. I just kind of whittled it down to, you know, good old-fashioned networking, cold calling, warm calling, calling pre-existing customers. And, you know, the digital marketing has been really, really good.
So the cold calling, the networking, that's always remained, even to this day.
Yeah. There's a thing about just connecting with the customers and staying front of mind, especially with a t-shirt. You know, it's pretty easy for me to go on and look at what piece of art they put on, and you know, that'll trigger a memory of the experience that I might have had with that customer, and talk to them about the story behind that garment. And it's just an easy way to talk and have a conversation, and you know, see if they need some new stuff, you know, for the near future.
Okay. What's some of the biggest mistakes you've made in starting this business? Think back to year one. Give us two or three to our viewers who hopefully will avoid those mistakes.
Yeah, number one is hiring. Mm-hmm. That's something that when I got into this, I'd never done. I'd never been a boss. I'd never been an employer. I was always an employee. So learning how to hire properly and to find people that fulfill the needs that I need and want, and you know, making sure that they're good employees is a really, really tough, was a tough thing for me to deal with, and it took a long time. And I kind of have a hybrid approach where I actually have my employees do the involved in the interviewing process, mm-hmm. and then I'll get in on the second round because I want them to have some accountability.
Right.
And I want them to like the person that they're working with. It's a very tight-knit group of people here.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing is margins. I mean, with you know, any business, it's about managing margins, you know. I want to make sure that I'm able to, you know, produce a product and be able to pay myself, pay my employees, and, you know, take care of all the overhead. And, you know, working on making sure that those margins are substantial enough to sustain a business is, you know,
paramount.
That's what it's all about.
Make sure you comment below about anything that stood out to you, any suggestion, any idea that you heard that really has an impact on you. Make sure you tell us about that below. We read all our comments, and let's get back to the video. All right, Sanford, we got some blitz questions for you. Our audience already know what that is. We'll just get straight into it. What's the one thing you cannot start your day without? And don't say t-shirt.
Coffee,
okay. What will your ultimate superpower be, business superpower be? If it's something essential like Steve Jobs, you get bonus points.
Printing money,
oh, that's awesome, okay. What's the craziest risk you've ever taken?
Starting a business.
That's pretty important. Why do you think only a handful of startups succeed? Are you just smarter than the rest of us?
I think it's marketing. Just being good at networking and marketing.
Boom, voila. If you could have anyone in this world endorse your business, who would it be and why?
Elon Musk. He's like the biggest influencer right now.
I love it. Okay, a couple more for you. If aliens came to Earth today, shut all the businesses in Portland down, came to you as the last one, what would you tell them to stay open? How would you convince them that you need to stay open? I know. It's a tough question. You're about to be shut down, Sanford.
Stay open. I would tell them that the world cannot go on without custom T-shirts.
There you go. You need to print them some alien T-shirt, and they're going to be like, man, you're a guy now. Okay. Let's talk about seasonality of this business, right? You've got the highs, you've got the lows. What are the high seasons, busy seasons, and what are the low seasons? And what do you do, especially in the low seasons, to continue to be profitable?
Yeah, so January, February, halfway through March are generally pretty slow. Those are times and opportunities I'll take to reach out to old customers. I'll pick up the phone, and then I'll do an email. And then the most important aspect or thing to do after that is the follow-up.
Right.
You know, it's something that's super simple and is really important because it's that nudging of the customer that I want to make sure that I'm, you know, remembered.
You stay on top of their mind.
Yep. And it helps a lot. And I've noticed a big difference in me nudging versus not nudging and doing that follow-up.
During especially the slow seasons.
Correct. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. And then, you know, in the busier times, you know, I'm still doing that and I'm working on my SEO. So I've got a person in the franchise that helps me keep up to date and doing the analytics that they're way more of an expert at than I am.
Okay.
And that helps tremendously.
In terms of equipment, what's the most necessary equipment for starting a t-shirt business? And I don't want to dissect that question into, in terms of your services, what equipment is the most expensive? And what equipment's the least expensive?
The most important piece of equipment is my printer. That's what I make my money off of primarily here.
Wow, okay.
And that, as I said, is about a $22,000 investment. The least expensive piece of equipment when I'm doing the heat transfers is the actual heat press, which...
Is it just back there?
Yeah, I've got three of them. And, you know, this is one. And then I've got a bigger clamshell, a 16 by 14, I believe. And those are great. They just, you know, you put the heat transfer paper on, press it, peel it, and it's quick and easy.
How many employees do you have? What's their typical pay? And any tips on hiring?
Yeah, so I got three employees right now. I have two designers and then a guy that's solely production, does most of the printing.
Okay.
I pay, you know, anywhere from 14 to 16-ish an hour. Yeah, I just use, Indeed. Primarily for hiring and
done well for you.
Yeah. Now it does. You know, but the process with that is, I've got a list of questions that I ask, and I'm more interested. I've got the credentials of the person. You know, they got to have Photoshop or Illustrator skills. Ideally, a little bit of customer service. Background, restaurants, or I've got Adam over here from FedEx. That goes a long way because it's such a customer oriented heavy, business and interacting with people. I want to make sure that they're kind, they're friendly, they communicate well, they're quick at emails, and they're clear about, setting expectations to the customers. And I just want them to make sure that, I want my employees to make customers feel welcome.
So the t-shirt printing business is pretty competitive, would you say?
Yeah.
How does Big Frog help you set yourself up apart from all the other guys on the Portland streets here?
Yeah, so there's a couple things. And I reached out to a lot, if not all of the t-shirt companies in the area because what sets me apart in Big Frog is that we provide direct-to-garment printing, which a lot of people don't do. I go to them, I introduce myself, and I can say, hey, I can provide another revenue stream for you. If you've got a customer that only wants, 5, 10, 15 shirts, you don't want to burn the screens, you don't want to do the setup, you don't want to spend the time making those shirts, why don't you outsource to me? So with that idea, this concept in Portland, I feel like with the other screen printers in the area, the idea that the pie is big enough for everybody to have a slice has really garnered some really great relationships in the community and with other people that do sort of what I do, and not looking at each other as competitors, but as partners.
Right. the most important thing, t-shirt printing business, these are the three things you need to focus on.
Yeah, I think, you know, hiring people to do the things that you're not good at, you know, is something I think a lot of, you know, business people hear, and I think has worked really well for me. You know, believe it or not, I'm not good at a lot of things, and, you know, hiring people that do those things better is really, really important. You know, the margin, I can't emphasize enough about, you
know,
managing the margins. And there's no get-rich-quick scheme here. It's all just, you know, pound on the pavement, slow and steady, you know, consistent customer interaction that's positive, and, you know, solid SEO, you know, work and making sure that you're top of the page in the, on the internet.
That's awesome. Okay. Thank you so much. It's been good, and we'll get your story out there.
And I want to thank you guys, camera guy. Thanks, man. And
always.
Thank you. Yeah, yeah. He's the forgotten one. holding it down over there.
Well, that's a wrap for this two-part series of Big Frog here in Portland. I hope you guys really enjoyed it. Took away a lot of good stuff that will help you grow your business and be successful. Subscribe to our channel. Like this video. And comment below about what you heard. We read all of those comments and appreciate you a lot.